Hello everybody, and welcome to this short video tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to create a DosBox shortcut for your favorite DOS games without having to use the console commands every time you want to play it. Simply like this Daggerfall. So first things first, we want to go to the DOSBox directory. We're going to go to local disk. If you have a Windows 64-bit machine, it'll be in program files x86. And if you have a 32-bit machine, it will be in program files. I have 64, so we're going to go to DOSBox. We're going to right-click the DOSBox exe, go to program files, compatibility, and make sure it is running as administrator. Now, what we're going to do is open up DOSBox. We're going to type in config config space hyphen write conf. We're going to write a config file, and it's going to be blood. I'm going to be using the game Blood as an example today. So if you move this out of the way, you can see that this file has just been created. It does not have an extension, so it does not have any sort of attachment to any program. Now, CFG files or configuration files, I already have set to run with Notepad. So if I move this over to the desktop, click continue, right click and rename this to .cfg, open it up, and it is indeed a Notepad document. So what we're going to do is I'm going to use the console commands that I would when I wanted to start my Blood game and put them at the very bottom of this auto executable. So we're going to mount c/games/blood. Then at the next line, we're going to change the hard drive to C, and we're going to load the game Blood. And that's simple as that. Now, with this, it will automatically load the game with one other step. However, there are a couple other little tweaks to this configuration folder, or configuration file, I'm sorry, that will definitely help the game out in the long run, playing with and good and have stability. So we're going to scroll up. We're going to make sure that this one is set at cycles max. Then we're going to go to memory size. I always make sure that my memory size is 32. And when you go to output, I always put OpenGL. Then what we can do from here is save the file. We're done with it. Drag it back into the DOSBox directory, click continue, and you're done with the configuration of that. Now what you need to do is create a shortcut to DOSBox on the desktop. I'm gonna rename this Blood, and then we're gonna go to properties, go to the target, go space hyphen conf and blood.cfg. Now whenever you use this shortcut, it will actually load with the configuration file automatically. Go ahead and load this up, and it will load Blood. Could not detect FM chip. Okay, let's try Blood again. This game gives me that error sometimes. I don't know why. Try it again. Try it again. See, it's just the game. Sometimes it does it, sometimes it not. Doesn't. I think it actually has to do with DOSBox. I'm not really sure. But it loads no problem. It might be my installation of the game as well. So, I'm going to go ahead and quit. And that is it for today's video. A quick little thing. I'm going to go back to properties. Since I have the CD-ROM of Blood on my hard drive already from installing it, in my games folder, I'm going to go to Blood CD1, which is actually the name of the CD-ROM. I'm going to click the Blood icon, open, OK, and apply. And as you can see, it has the Blood icon. So with that, I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will catch you guys later.